Welcome to Cyber World YT. Like and subscribe if you are new here. Also, follow me on Instagram for in case of any queries. Have you ever thought about what the first cyber war looked like? Let us go back to Estonia in 2007. Estonia was having a great time on the internet. The country is known for its technological advances, but a politically charged wave was about to make a storm. The process started when a memorial to a Soviet soldier was taken down, which caused a lot of trouble. The monument, which stood for Soviet freedom, was moved from the center of Tallinn, the capital, to a less noticeable spot. This move made a lot of people angry, especially Russian-speaking people, and it led to riots for several days. But the real storm wasn't over yet. All of a sudden, Estonia's online world was attacked. A bunch of distributed denial-of-service, DDoS, attacks flooded the computers in the country, making things very difficult. Some of the main targets were government websites, banks, and news sources. The strikes were on a scale that had never been seen before. The country of Estonia was brought to its knees. Most people there paid their bills, did their shopping, and used government services online. The attack was a masterful way to cause trouble. It completely destroyed Estonia's digital infrastructure. During the weeks it ran, a lot of money was lost, and public services stopped working. The attackers didn't have faces because their names were hidden by the internet. There were, however, accusations that Russia was to blame, which Russia strongly rejected. After the attack, Estonia had to rebuild and improve its computer defenses. But Estonia wasn't the only one who learned a lesson. The whole world paid close attention because they knew that cyber war could mess up a whole country. As soon as countries around the world realized that the digital world had become a new war, they started to step up their security measures. It was a wake-up call for everyone that this attack on Estonia showed how cyber war can mess up a country. As a stark warning, wars are no longer just fought on land, sea, and air. They are also fought in the vast, unknowable world of cyberspace. Fast forward 3 years to 2010, a major tech giant was on the receiving end of a sophisticated cyber attack. This wasn't just any cybercrime. It was a full-scale digital attack planned with military accuracy and given the secret name Operation Aurora. Advanced persistent threats carried out a string of cyber attacks called Operation Aurora. The main aim was none other than Google, which is a giant in the tech world. It was the attacker's goal to get to Google's intellectual property, and even scarier, the personal information of HR advocates. It was said that the attack could be tracked back to China, which makes it possible that the Chinese government was involved. This was a big surprise that had huge effects on safety around the world. It was a scary reminder that cyber warfare supported by the government was not just an idea, but a real danger. There were many effects of Operation Aurora. It made things very difficult between China and the US, and Google even said it might leave China for good. The way companies thought about cyber threats also changed because of it. In the past, they were just minor problems that IT teams had to deal with. Now, they were real threats that needed strategic planning and high-level attention. Operation Aurora had a bigger effect on the world of cybersecurity than just Google and ties between the US and China. Governments and companies all over the world were shocked by how easy it would be to use computers for spying and war. The attack caused a change in the way cybersecurity is handled around the world, with a stronger focus on proactive defense and threat information. The events of 2010 were a stark warning of how cyber threats change over time. The way wars and spying are done has changed along with the digital world. As the world becomes more linked, the line between the digital and the real is becoming less clear. Cyber attacks like Operation Aurora show how real and dangerous these threats can be. Operation Aurora was a stark reminder that even tech giants aren't immune to cyber threats. No matter your size or rank, the digital battlefield doesn't care. In the world of cybersecurity, the only thing that stays the same is change. Consider a computer bug that can hurt people physically. That's what happened with the Stuxnet worm in 2010. This wasn't your typical cyber attack where virtual assets were compromised. No, this was a whole new ballgame, where a computer worm was used as a weapon to cause tangible destruction. The worm called Stuxnet was harmful, and it went after systems that controlled and collected data. This is the main part of an industrial business that controls everything from power plants to traffic lights. The target in this case, Iran's nuclear facilities. This wasn't a random act of cyber vandalism. Stuxnet was made to get into Iran's nuclear enrichment program and stop it from working. And it did it with a scary level of accuracy. Once it got into the system, the worm changed the centrifuge's speeds, making them spin out of control and finally destroy themselves. It did this while sending normal readings back to the operators. The damage was big, and it set Iran's nuclear program back a few years. But what might have been even scarier was realizing that cyber attacks had changed. No longer were they confined to the digital realm. Now they could do physical damage that could shut down important systems and even kill people. Stuxnet changed everything. It showed how powerful computer weapons can be and started a new era of war. It was like the digital battlefield had come to life, and the risks were higher than ever. But who planned this attack that had never been done before? The truth is, we may never know for sure. There has been a lot of talk about possible state-sponsored participation, but the real culprits have never been caught. What we do know is that Stuxnet was a very complex operation that needed a lot of resources to carry out. The implications of Stuxnet are still being felt today. The worm woke up governments all over the world to how important it is to have strong protection measures in place right away. It also led to a heated argument about the morality of cyber warfare and the damage that could be done by accident. Stuxnet marked a new era of cyber threats, where a virtual attack could have physical consequences. It was a stark warning that the lines between the real and virtual worlds are getting less clear in this digital age. And as we depend on digital systems more, the chance of cyber attacks that affect the real world only rises. It was the worst cyber attack Hollywood had ever seen in 2014. Sony Pictures was the one hurt. It wasn't just another hack. It was a full-on cyber attack that shocked people all over the world. Let's get things started. Sony Pictures, one of the biggest movie studios, was getting ready to release The Interview, a spoof comedy about the made-up death of North Korea's leader. Then, Sony was attacked without notice. A lot of information was stolen, like scripts for unfinished movies, personal emails, and private information about employees. It was embarrassing and did a lot of harm. The cyber attackers didn't just want to steal, they also wanted to make people look bad. They shared the information, which made the news and was bad for Sony's reputation. The size and boldness of the cyber attack had never been seen before. But who did it? North Korea was blamed by the US government. The secretive state had already spoken out against The Interview, calling it an act of war. North Korea, on the other hand, denied any role. This caused a heated argument among cybersecurity experts, with some backing the idea that the government was behind it, and others not believing it. Nobody knows who did it, but the Sony Pictures hack changed the way we think about cyber dangers. It woke Hollywood up by showing how easy it is for attacks like this to happen in the business. Because of what happened, cybersecurity strategies have changed a lot in the entertainment business and elsewhere. The Sony Pictures hack did have an impact on more than just Hollywood, though. It also had big global effects and made things even more tense between the US and North Korea. It even started a bigger talk about cybersecurity around the world, with countries realizing they need to work together to fight cyber threats. That no one is safe from online threats, not even Hollywood, was made clear by the Sony Pictures hack. In 2017, a cyber attack of unprecedented scale struck, causing havoc worldwide. Here comes the well-known WannaCry malware attack. It wasn't just any attack, it was a global disease that spread all over the world and caused a lot of chaos. When it comes to cyber attacks, WannaCry changed everything. This ransomware worm went after PCs that were running the Microsoft Windows operating system. It encrypted files and asked for Bitcoin as payment. How bad the attack was? Very big. WannaCry affected more than 200,000 computers in 150 countries. It happened in all kinds of places, from schools and hospitals to workplaces and government offices. The UK's National Health Service was one of the worst affected, with important medical procedures being held up and patient records being inaccessible. Businesses all over the world stopped working because they couldn't get to their important data. The cost was huge. It was thought to be in the billions of dollars. In addition to the damage it caused right away, WannaCry changed the way we think about cyber threats in a big way. we learned that everyone can be hurt by the risks in the digital world. People needed to wake up after WannaCry. It showed us how weak our systems are and what happens when we don't take care of things. It showed how important it is to keep software up to date, have strong backup systems, and be proactive about cybersecurity. But it also showed us how powerful it is to work together. As soon as the attack was over, people in the global cybersecurity community worked together to stop the ransomware from spreading and fix systems that had been damaged. The WannaCry attack woke people up around the world to the need for stronger security measures. The sixth cyber attack that made headlines was the Marriott data breach in 2018. This was no small-time hack. It was a mammoth breach that exposed the personal data of up to 500 million customers. Data included names, passport numbers, addresses, phone numbers, and even credit card information. The scale and nature of the data stolen was simply staggering, making it one of the most significant breaches in history. This attack wasn't a quick hit and run either. The hackers had access to the Marriott system since 2014, silently siphoning off data for 4 long years before the breach was discovered. It was a stark reminder that cyber attacks aren't always immediate. They can be slow, methodical, and incredibly damaging. Aftermath of the Marriott data breach was equally significant. The breach cost the company hundreds of millions of dollars in remediation costs, legal fees, and penalties. It also caused a substantial hit to Marriott's reputation, with many questioning the company's commitment to data security. The fallout didn't stop at the company's doorstep. The Marriott data breach had a ripple effect throughout the cybersecurity world. Served as a potent reminder of the vulnerability of personal data and the devastating consequences of a data breach. It spurred businesses around the globe to reevaluate and bolster their cybersecurity measures. Attacks served as a wake-up call for many businesses about the importance of securing customer data. The Marriott data breach wasn't just a story of a single company's failure. It was a cautionary tale for all of us about the digital dangers lurking in our interconnected world. Next on our list is the Capital One hack that occurred in 2019. This breach was a stark reminder that even the most secure systems can fall prey to a determined hacker. Perpetrator was a former Amazon Web Services employee named Paige Thompson. Using her knowledge of the company's infrastructure, she exploited a misconfigured firewall to gain access to Capital One's data. It was a sophisticated attack, exploiting a tiny crack in the system's armor and blowing it wide open. The damage was extensive, affecting over 100 million people in the United States and 6 million in Canada. Personal information, including names, addresses, phone numbers, and even social security numbers were compromised. In some cases, bank account numbers were exposed. It was a treasure trove for identity thieves, a chilling reminder of the potential consequences of a data breach. One's response was swift. They quickly identified and fixed the configuration vulnerability that allowed the breach. The company notified affected customers and offered free credit monitoring and identity protection. But the damage was done. Trust was broken, and rebuilding it would be an uphill task. The hacker was apprehended by the FBI and charged with computer fraud and abuse, but the incident left a black mark on Capital One's record, a reminder of the vulnerability of digital systems. Capital One hack was a wake-up call to the banking industry. It underscored the importance of robust cybersecurity measures and the potential consequences of complacency. It showed that even large, established institutions are not immune to Cyber Attack 7. The incident also highlighted the dangers posed by insider threats. The hacker was not a faceless entity in a distant land, but a former employee with intimate knowledge of the system. It's a reminder that cybersecurity is not just about guarding against external threats, but also about managing internal risks. This incident highlighted the need for robust cybersecurity measures, even within large, established institutions. In 2020, we faced one of the most sophisticated cyber attacks in history. The SolarWinds hack 2020 was not just an attack on a private company, it was a calculated move against the very infrastructure that keeps our digital world spinning. This attack was an orchestrated cyber espionage campaign that left no stone unturned. It infiltrated the systems of around 18,000 organizations worldwide, including top-tier government agencies and Fortune 500 companies. This wasn't your run-of-the-mill data breach. The hackers, suspected to be of Russian origin, used a Trojan horse strategy, hiding malicious code within routine software updates for SolarWinds' Orion platform. Inside the systems, the attackers had unrestricted access to sensitive information, enabling them to monitor and potentially manipulate critical operations. Breadth and depth of this attack were unprecedented, with victims including the US Treasury Department, the Department of Homeland Security, and tech giant Microsoft, among others. Global response was swift but complicated. The extent of the breach and identifying the perpetrators required a coordinated effort from cybersecurity experts across the globe. The US government pointed fingers at Russia, but the Russian government denied involvement, leading to increased tension between the two nations. This incident served as a stark reminder of the vulnerability of our interconnected digital world, brought to the forefront the importance of robust cybersecurity measures, not just for individual organizations, but for our global digital infrastructure as a whole. This wasn't just an attack, it was a wake-up call, underscored the widespread implications of a well-orchestrated cyber attack. From governments to corporations, no one is immune, and the stakes are higher than ever. Must learn from these incidents and invest in stronger, more resilient cybersecurity defenses, because the next attack is not a question of if, but when. This cyber attack underscored the widespread implications of a well-orchestrated cyber attack. The year 2021 was not without its share of cyber attacks, with the Microsoft Exchange server hack and the Colonial Pipeline ransomware attack making headlines. September, Microsoft's Exchange server, a widely used email and calendaring server, fell victim to a significant cyber attack. The perpetrators, a group named Cyber Group 9, linked to the Russian state, exploited zero-day vulnerabilities in the server software, targeting an estimated 200,000 organizations worldwide. This attack allowed unauthorized access to sensitive data and potentially set up future attacks. Microsoft swiftly released emergency patches to rectify the issue, but the impact was already widespread, highlighting the critical importance of timely software updates in cybersecurity. Just a couple of months later, in November, the largest fuel pipeline in the United States, Colonial Pipeline, was hit by a ransomware attack. Cyber Group 10, a criminal hacking group believed to be based in Eastern Europe, was responsible. The attack forced Colonial to shut down approximately 6,000 miles of pipeline, leading to a significant disruption in the supply of gasoline, diesel, and jet fuel across the eastern US. To restore its systems, Colonial Pipeline paid a ransom of roughly $5 million in Bitcoin to the hackers. This incident underscored the vulnerability of critical infrastructure to cyber attacks and the costly implications of such breaches. These attacks served as stark reminders of the persistent and evolving threats in the realm of cybersecurity. As we've seen, cyber attacks pose a significant threat to our digital world. From the Marriott data breach in 2018, which saw the sensitive information of around 500 million guests compromised, to the SolarWinds hack in 2020, a sophisticated attack that breached multiple US government agencies, the stakes couldn't be higher. These attacks, along with the Capital One hack, the Microsoft Exchange server hack, and the Colonial Pipeline ransomware attack, highlight the need for robust cybersecurity measures. They show us that no entity, no matter how large or small, is immune to these threats. But there's hope. Cybersecurity professionals around the world are working tirelessly to safeguard our information and systems. They are the silent guardians, the digital sentinels, constantly innovating and adapting to new threats. Their role is critical in preventing such attacks and minimizing the damage when they do occur. In a world where our lives are increasingly online, cybersecurity isn't just important, it's essential. Thanks for joining us. Remember, knowledge empowers us. Stay curious, stay secure, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.